So good morning, everybody.
Good morning.
I'm Rajendra Mamlakethura. So for the past couple of years, I have been working with Dr. Bob Oglesby and Dr. Clem Trove to establish a regional consortium or a regional framework that could bring together climate scientists from Latin American and Caribbean countries together so that they can collaborate and work together. Okay, so I should start off with saying that it is not a traditional research project, so we didn't start off with a research question and then try to answer that over the course of the last 2 years. So we took a little different approach. So because of that, let me take a step back and give you a little bit of background on what we are doing and why we do the things that we do. So we are regional climate modelers. Okay, so by that I mean we use regional climate models to produce high resolution climate data for different parts of the world. So in our group, we specifically use one model, which is called the Weather Research and Forecasting Model, or WARF for short. So, and for this particular project, we are focusing on Latin America and the Caribbean region. So why do we need to do regional climate modeling? So the simple, the most straightforward answer is to produce high-resolution climate data for specific regions. So if you take global climate models, they do a pretty good job of simulating the climate at the global scale. So that means you get a pretty good idea about the big picture, but if you really want to zoom down into a region and figure out what's going on there, and then sort of look at climate change and its implications, global climate models are not very helpful because they simulate the climate at about a resolution of 100 kilometers. So that is where regional climate models come into play. So we can take the output from global models and feed it into a regional model and then produce really high resolution, say about 5 to 10 kilometer resolution data that we can then use to assess climate change over a specific region. So this is especially useful over regions that have really complex topography or regions that have, you know, a lot of land ocean or land water boundaries, or regions that have highly varying land use and land coverage use. So that means because of the high resolution, the regional models are able to capture those features and sort of capture the effects those features have on the regional and local climate. So we use these models to simulate the climate for Latin America and the Caribbean. And one of the main reasons that we focus on this region is that studies have shown that these are regions that have already experienced negative impacts because of climate change, and that these regions will continue to do so over the coming century. And also, these regions have a lot of existing knowledge gaps and a lot of unanswered scientific questions, especially in terms of regional climate modeling. So these are really good areas to work on if you are interested in this kind of stuff. So because of that, we started working with a number of different countries in this region. And so we worked with individual countries, providing them with training on how to use these models, how to run the models, then how to make use of those output. And then at some point, we realized, you know, we have a lot of things going on, but we were really coordinating them, or there was no collaboration going on. So we realized that if we could bring all this together under one framework, we could actually achieve more and sort of give the scientists in the region a chance to network with each other and sort of carry the work forward even once our project is done. So that is where we came up with the idea for a regional consortium for climate change for Latin America and the Caribbean. So the aim is to bring the scientists of these regions together, give them the necessary skills and tools to carry out regional climate modeling, and then actually make use of that for applied and practical purposes. And then we can answer any of the existing knowledge gaps and fill in any of the questions that need to be answered. So this is where the funding from a Water for Food Institute came in. So for the past 2 years, with the help of that funding, we have been working to put together a framework for regional consortium. So we have been working with the Inter-American Development Bank to secure funding for the regional consortium, which we have done. And we have also been working with CATALA, which is the Water Center for Humid Tropics of Latin America and the Caribbean, so that they would act as sort of the physical home base for all of these activities that we have planned for the next 2.5 years. And in addition to that, we've also been working with a number of different countries in the region, trying to get them to formally commit resources, personnel, and time into this effort. So this figure here provides a snapshot of what we have been working on for the past year. So each of these boxes, I can spend hours just talking about, you know, each activity. But I'm trying to, you know, focus on the most important ones. And I'm going to start with this box here at the corner, called First Regional Consortium Workshop, because that is what we have been working towards for 2 years, trying to put all the things together, establish the consortium, and get this going. So I'll focus a lot on that. And then I will also talk a little bit about some other interesting stuff that came out of this effort. So the status of the regional consortium and the first workshop in Panama. So we were able to actually get 10 leading institutions from the 10 countries in the region to commit time, personnel, and resources to this effort. So here you can see, I mean, it's a truly international collaborative effort. And we will be meeting for the first time for the first workshop, which is the first out of a series of 5, will be held in a few weeks' time in Panama City at CATALAC headquarters. So I'm really, really excited about this. So this is pretty much what everything's been leading up to, like all the hard work that has been going into it. And you know, I will finally get to meet all the people I've been corresponding and Skyping, you know, face-to-face for the first time. So it's a really great feeling. So what we're going to do, since this is the first workshop of an entire project, this is going to be more of planetary in nature. We are trying to sort of set the roadmap and sort of streamline the rest of the project based on participant feedback. So we are going to focus on the participant needs at this stage. So we were really lucky to find a week that works for all 10 participants. So they have already confirmed that they'll be attending. And then also we will have about 4 personnel from CATALAC joining us at the workshop. So what we're planning to do is, you know, first of all, get the participants a chance to meet each other, sort of get to know each other, then sort of get some sort of networking collaborations going on. And then we want to hear from the participants, sort of to get everybody on the same page about what sort of research they have been doing and sort of get them up to date on what sort of climate studies that have been done in the region. Then we also want the participants to sort of discuss the kind of issues their institution or country wants to address specifically through the regional consortium. So what are the pressing issues or the scientific questions that they would like answered through this. So, and through that, we are also going to break the participants into what we call working groups, so that we can sort of get people together that have common interests or themes working together so that they can spend their time more productively. So to get that going, we are currently doing a pre-workshop survey so we have sort of official documentation to get their feedback and sort of have an idea going in what their key interests are. So, pretty much we are, and then of course we want to make sure that the goals that we have set right now, they align with the interests of the participants. We've had the discussion going, but it's always easier to sort these things out and clarify when you actually meet face to face. So that is also going to be part of the first workshop. So in addition to all of that, we will be having some meetings with some representatives from CATALAC to talk about some education outreach activities that we could undertake in the next couple of years. So in addition to all of that, one of the most important things we would be focusing on at the workshop is this online visualization tool called the Map Maker. So up to now we have done a number of regional modeling studies for the Latin American region. So we have all that data and it's archived here at the Holland Computing Center. So this is just a very user-friendly interface that people can use even without any kind of specialized knowledge to make use of that end product. So they can use this software or just go on there and sort of take a look at what the climate data tells you without even really having to know too much about it. So this has proven really popular with some of the countries we've worked with so far. So they have expressed interest in developing this into a fully functional platform that we can share with the public, because they feel this is a really easy and great way to access the data we have produced through a number of different efforts, and they want to continue to do that in the future. So we are going to present the latest version to them and get their feedback on how to get their suggestions and comments on what they want to see from this and what improvements they like to see made to the map maker. So that is going to be a big part of the project for the next 2 years. So that's what we've been doing for the past few days, past year, and for the past couple of months we are actually preparing to go to Panama and hold the workshop. So that has been our key focus, but while we were working on that, we actually came across a few more interesting opportunities that are sort of complementary to what we are doing with the regional consortium. So I listed a couple of them here. So the first one is the Caribbean Initiative. We have been working on this proposal for sort of putting together the framework for a little over 12 months now. So this is something similar to the regional consortium, but we are going to bring in climate scientists, climate modelers, and policymakers from the Caribbean region. So it's going to be focused on the Caribbeans, and we are going to aim our workshop at a much broader audience. And at the same time, in addition to providing training, we are going to also complete a comprehensive set of high-resolution model simulations for the Caribbean region. So we are currently working with the University of West Indies, MONA, and the Caribbean Community Climate Change Center to streamline this effort. And while we are trying to put everything together and get funding for the project, we've been invited to the Caribbean modelers meeting later this year, just so that we can make sure our efforts are coordinated with the ongoing regional efforts. So this is another interesting opportunity we had, which was to do a workshop on seasonal forecasting in Colombia, so which was held last year, July of last year. So we went there, and so they had some specific requests, specific things they wanted done. So we held that workshop for them. And it was pretty successful. So we are waiting on the plans for the second workshop there. So these were the main things that were related to the regional consortium. But in addition to that, I have been working on a couple of other projects that make use of WAF to generate high-resolution climate data. So one study was focused over Sri Lanka. So this is a really ideal place to study climate change, because first of all, it's a relatively small island in the Indian Ocean. So it has complex topography, varying land use changes, and not much has been done over the region. So it's both exciting and challenging, because since nothing has been done, you run into a lot of issues that were unexplored before. But at the same time, you get to define all your research questions, because pretty much nothing has been done. So this has been a really good learning experience for us. We've got to explore a lot of different avenues, which we hope to implement once we get to the project on Latin America. I am going to skip this one and just go over the last project that we've been working on. So this is more focused on Bolivia. Again, it's wavelengths at high resolution. But this is a very comprehensive set of wavelengths that we've done for the region. And it sort of serves as a template that we are going to use for the regional consortium and the Caribbean Initiative. Sort of looks, takes a very comprehensive look at the climate change problem in the region. So we hope to take from this and build upon this as we go forward. So pretty much that's a very brief description of what we've been doing for the past year. I would like to take this opportunity to thank the Waterfall Food Institute for this really, really wonderful opportunity. Because for the past couple of years, I got the chance to work with leading experts from a number of different countries, you know, collaborate with a number of different organizations, and of course, I get the chance to travel, so that's always a plus. So, I mean, I wouldn't have had that opportunity without the support from you, so thank you very much.